on the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again.
Right, this is the Austin Champ front axle. Well, he's primed all this side, so we're going to renew these boots. This one here, well, he hasn't painted this side because we're going to strip this off first. So we're going to do this boot here, the outer boot, and the inner boot. So Willie's just going to start undo these bolts on the bottom of the cradle. Ooh, lovely. This is the Austin Champ that the front axle's come out of. In case anyone's wondering what an Austin Champ was. There you go. 1950s. And that's one that's already been restored. Just needs a radiator putting on that one. Lovely vehicles. So we've taken the bolts out of there. And the ones down the back. So this lot here will all flip over. Stuff actually coming off. Right, so we've undone the top arm inner mount, so we just simply fold that out the way. Let the engine crane down a bit. We've just got it supported on the engine crane for the minute, because we don't want it to drop out the master spline. Go on, that's it. There we go. Spin that out the way. Let that drop down there. Right. Now what we need to do is mark the master spline so they don't drop out, and then we know where they went back in. Right, so we've got the hub supported with the engine crane. We've marked the drum in relation to the back plate. You can see the shaft coming through here out the first gaiter. All right, but the most important thing before you do it, we've cut the old boot off here, is you've got to mark where my finger is, the inner shaft with the ball that's going onto the outer shaft. That's got a master spline on it. If you let that drop out, you're in a world of pain. Right, just use the top arm to just gently tap itself out of the spline. See it there? See where I've marked it? Me and Willie are experts on these, we've done dozens of them. Right, just knock it off there, we'll do the rest. Top arm to just gently bang this out like that until we see the spline. There. Now then, when it gets to about there, Woolly will get a bit of Tipex mark.
I can't Tipex that.
Can you not?
No.
Maybe it's a bit more. Hang on. A bit more out. Can you see it there, Woolly? Yeah, you'll get it there. So I'll hold it there, and then we'll put a Tipex mark on the spline, because it's on a master spline. And if you lose that, then you're in a world of pain. Yeah, that's that one there, in line with where we are there. Yep, that's good. There you go, jobs are good. Right, that's the axle split. So basically all we did was undo this top plate, hinge this whole top arm down, which then folds the whole thing down on the trunnion. You've got a set of splines up here, which is master spline. So the most important thing you need to do is mark that spline there, or any of the splines, and mark the hub. The hub's turned now, but we've marked the hub in relation to the drum. It's turned now, but it doesn't matter, because when we put it back together, you put that together, which lines this spline up, which lines up with that spline on the master spline. And job will be a good one. but we're not going to put it back together yet because we're going to put an oil seal in here that's leaking, and I'll take another video of that. Right, so this oil seal in here was no good, so I'm just going to get my machine. I've picked it already, so I'm just going to pop that out. Hang on. There we go. There we go. So we'll renew that oil seal there, and the ball's actually in really good condition, the chrome and everything, so that'll live another day. Get the new seal put in, and then we'll do another video putting the boots on. Job's a good one. Well, that's it all stripped, so me and Willie have done a few of these in our time, so I hope we made it look easy, and I hope it helps anyone else that's doing them. So, and if you enjoyed it, don't forget to like and subscribe.